Hello all, today we will discuss about examination of neck veins in cardiovascular system examination. Examination of neck veins is to assess approximately the mean right atrial pressure and to study the waveforms. First, about the jugular venous pressure. It is the vertical height from the sternal angle to the zone of transition of distended and collapsed internal jugular veins. When measured with the patient reclining at 45 degree, normally it is about 4 to 5 cm. Right internal jugular vein is selected because it is larger, straighter and has no valves. It is situated between two heads of sternomastoid. Patient position in examination of JVP. Position the patient's upper thorax so that the column of blood in the internal jugular vein is visible in the neck. Lower the pressure in the venous system, more supine the patient's position should be. Higher the pressure, more upright the patient's position should be. So this is how we measure jugular venous pressure. JVP as indicator of mean right atrial pressure. Height of the pulsating column is an indicator of mean right atrial pressure. The center of the right atrium is about 5 cm from the sternal angle of Lewis. Vertical height of the column of blood in the neck from the sternal angle can be estimated, to which 5 cm is added to obtain an estimate of mean right atrial pressure. This can be converted to millimeter Hg by multiplying by 0.736. Normal values are less than 8 cm of blood or less than 6 mm mercury. This estimation may be erroneous, deformed chest walls or malpositioning of the heart. Causes of elevated jugular venous pressure. Unilateral non-pulsatile in innominate vein thrombosis. Bilateral non-pulsatile in superior vena cava obstruction. Massive right-sided pleural effusion. Bilateral pulsatile, cardiac causes, cardiac failure, tricuspid stenosis, tricuspid regurgitation, constrictive pericarditis, cardiac tamponade, pulmonary, COPD, corpulmonale, abdominal, ascites, pregnancy, iatrogenic, excess IV fluids. Most common cause of raised jugular venous pressure is congestive cardiac failure. Causes of fall in jugular venous pressure: hypovolemia, shock, Addison's disease. Next, jugular venous pulse. Jugular venous pulse is the reflection of phasic pressure changes in the right atrium. It consists of 3 positive waves and 2 negative troughs. 3 positive waves A, C, V and 2 negative troughs X, Y. Differentiating features between carotid artery pulse and jugular venous pulse. Carotid artery pulse is seen internal to the sternomastoid. Jugular venous pulse is seen in the triangle formed by the two heads of the sternomastoid and the clavicle. Carotid artery pulse is better palpable. Jugular venous pulse is better visible. Carotid artery pulse is predominant outward movement and jugular venous pulse is predominant inward movement. In carotid artery pulse, there will be one peak per heartbeat, whereas in jugular venous pulse, there will be 2 peaks per heartbeat. In carotid artery pulse, there will be no variation with posture or respiration. Whereas in jugular venous pulse, there will be variation with posture, respiration, abdominal compression. And carotid artery pulse is not obliterable and jugular venous pulse is obliterable. Next, waves in JVP. A wave is called atrial wave. Occurs due to right atrial contraction. C wave, closure wave due to carotid artery impact, tricuspid wall ascends. X wave due to right atrial relaxation, tricuspid wall descends. V wave, ventricular wave due to venous filling into the atria. Y wave, tricuspid wall opens. So A wave, so in this picture we can see A wave, C wave, X, V, Y. So A way, atrial contraction, X descent, atrial relaxation. V way, venous filling, right ventricular contraction, Y descent, atrial emptying. Abnormalities of JVP. A wave, absent A wave in atrial fibrillation and prominent A waves in pulmonary stenosis, pulmonary hypertension, tricuspid atresia or stenosis. Cannon waves, they are giant A waves seen in arrhythmias. It's regular in junctional rhythm and irregular in multiple ectopics, complete heart blocks. Independent A waves are seen in complete heart blocks. Prominent V wave in tricuspid regurgitation. Prominent X descent in constrictive pericarditis. Then Y descent, slow Y descent in tricuspid stenosis. Fast Y descent in tricuspid regurgitation. Absent Y descent in cardiac tamponade. Then Frederick sign, it's rapid fall and rise of JVP. That is rapid fall, steep Y descent and rise of JVP seen in constrictive pericarditis, tricuspid regurgitation. Kussmaul sign, it's inspiratory rise in JVP seen in constrictive pericarditis, restrictive cardiomyopathy, right ventricle infarct, right ventricle failure. Then abdominal jugular reflex. Firm compression is given in the periumbilical area for about 30 seconds. In normal individuals, the JVP rises transiently by less than 3 cm and falls down even when pressure is continued. Whereas in patients with right or left heart failure, JVP remains elevated. Reflex is positive in right or left heart failure, tricuspid regurgitation, elevated pulmonary artery wedge or central venous pressure, and abdominal jugular reflex is negative in Budd-Chiari syndrome. Thank you.